But let's talk about Timo Werner, shall we? It's the big transfer saga that is brewing right now. Yeah. It's a tug of war between Liverpool and Chelsea, which is not really, it's towards the end of that specific game of tug of war, because as we mentioned in the last episode, Liverpool have bowed out of the race to sign Timo Werner, and Chelsea are now front runners. But Robbie Fowler does not like him.
So I feel like there's a little bit of, I mean, there are two ways. Like, I'm a little conflicted about, I really wanted Timo Werner, so I'm a little upset the fact about him not coming to Liverpool. But I'm a little conflicted about Robbie Fowler's opinion about Timo Werner, because I feel a little bit of sour grapes, but I also get if he's coming from the side which argues that maybe Timo Werner might not be ready for a fully physical sort of football, and like maybe there's some sort of a Christian Pulisic style of like a way of going out as a Chelsea player once he goes to Chelsea. So I'm not sure, but definitely feels a little bit like sour grapes, like little bit, just a little bit.
It really does, right? Because I mean, he's a good player. He's performed really well for Leipzig this season. I think he's got some 31 goals to his name. And I mean, yeah, one can argue that with the front three that Liverpool have, who are probably the best in the world right now, is there really place for somebody like Timo Werner to come in and, you know, kind of help in that attacking front three? But it's weird, because Robbie Fowler also goes on to say something like, does he match up to the players you are signing him to challenge and replace? Not at Liverpool, maybe at Chelsea. So you can see the little bit of like passive aggressiveness that is coming in from Robbie Fowler, and it's just disrespectful, I feel.
No, it is. I don't know if it's like an old-timey footballer trying to say he's not ready for the physical game.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm just defending him. Like, if it was like Roy Keane saying it, I'd have been like, ah, ha, 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 ha. Been laughing at Roy Keane. But maybe because it's a Liverpool player, I'm just like kind of bad for him a little bit. But I really wish, because I also see, I feel like Tammy Abraham and Timo Werner are very similar players. Do you guys think they're similar players? I mean, Tammy Abraham. So
I think Tammy Abraham is more of a number nine, like an out and out striker, back to the goal, can hold up play, lay it off, make a run, tap the ball in, that sort
Timo
of a player.
Can at least carry
Timo
it.
Werner's, yeah, Timo's a little more number 10. I think he gives you more versatility in terms of, I think he can play on either wing, he can play in the center as a number 10, plus he can play as a lone striker as well. So he does benefit Liverpool's 4-3-3 system, where the front three have the freedom to kind of move positions between themselves and create havoc in the opposition half. I don't know if he fits into the Chelsea system, because essentially Chelsea would play him in Mason Mount's position. And play him behind Tammy Abraham as a deep lying forward. But, you know, it's just one of those things, right? Like, you've got Hakim Ziyech coming at Chelsea. And you know, he would provide some good balls for Tammy Abraham to finish. But I don't know if Chelsea need a Timo Werner at this stage. And I don't even know, honestly, if Liverpool needed a Timo Werner at this stage.
I'm all just slightly saying, hey, I think if there's one team that needs Timo Werner,
I'm not saying that at all. Even but, United does not need Timo Werner at all. Kai Havertz, though, I think we need. I'm just kidding. I think it's more of a defender is what we need at Man United. But of course, Liverpool pulled out of the Timo Werner chase because of financial troubles. And that's very understandable, because, of course, the pandemic has thrown every club's finances into a bit of disarray. And one can say, and one can agree with Liverpool by saying that, okay, listen, our front three is good. We don't need to spend 52 million for essentially a backup player. So I think it's a financially sound decision. Also, I heard on the Football Ramble podcast, these guys were talking about it, about how Liverpool planned to kind of beg Timo Werner in during the African Cup of Nations, where Sadio Mane would be away. But because the calendar has shifted, the African Cup of Nations will be happening much later. And then that need is not really there anymore, which is kind of interesting. So purely from a business point of view, I don't think you should be disheartened, Mukesh, that you're not getting Timo Werner.
So what I've also read in a couple of articles is that Timo Werner, he only signed a new contract last season, if I'm not mistaken, because his previous contract was running out this season.
Right.
And his new contract has a few clauses where his release clause drops every year that Leipzig don't win the league. So from what I read, Liverpool wanted to make a move for him, but they were holding on till the end of next season.
Right.
Because that would mean they'd be able to get him for a lot cheaper than right now. However, he is looking for a move, and he was very keen on a move to Liverpool. And a couple of times he's spoken about how flattered he was by the link to Liverpool.
Yeah.
But now that it becomes a thing of Liverpool will want him the next season and Chelsea want him now. And he's sort of feeling quite done with the Bundesliga, because a couple of times he's also said that he doesn't want to move to Bayern Munich because he wants to leave the league and try out a new league.
Yeah.
So I think it's the fact that Chelsea is allowing him to give him to move to the Premier League one season before Liverpool that is also helping him with that decision.